Okay, what were we doing? Do I have the volume turned way down? I do. Yes. Fix that. Y'all can hear the... Yes! Blessed Fat Bat! I need to add that to my Discord as well. I'll do that at some other point, though. Okay, looks like we're coming up here. You're not gonna let me just teleport, game? Blessed Fat Bat! Just chilling out in chat, doing Fat Bat things like Fat Bats do. Ah, it is a good day. Except we're doing this on veteran, and so the monsters are gonna be just chonk as hell. Hey, Philosophizer, welcome!
Yet.
Hope you're doing well. Thank you for the well wishes towards the weekend. It has thus far been pretty solid. We got cool new video games. I'm chilling out, work has been too terrible this week. The system works. I hope everything is going well on your end as well. That's right, I've got minions doing that. I should probably summon those guys. There we go. I really worry about the later boss fights in this expansion. They are going to be slogs. Our damage is just not there. Actually check, what's our gear look like? It would be easier to just come in here. Okay, so we're all physical, we got some trauma. Like, no fire. Realistically, what I should do is like pull all of my points out of like my shield throw and Vire's Might and just put them in fucking Force Wave and Blitz. And I bet you guys we would be just mowing through this stuff.
School's not ready.
School trip to Hawaii after being back for a week and a half. Man, I want to go to that school. Holy hell. Getting the beach episode out of the way nice and early, though, I guess. I'm glad you seem to be digging on the game, though. I've heard, nothing but good things about Persona 5. I played Persona 4, the original release, PS2, I think. Never finished it, but I enjoyed it. I know that there are, superior versions out now, Golden or whatever, and then there's Royale for 5. But, I don't know, those are games that, I would stream... Nope. Those are games that I would, stream if I were to play them, because otherwise I know that I would, start them and then never finish them. Alright. I gotta know. We're gonna go respec to Force Wave and Blitz. And I bet you guys, we are just gonna roll through this. We cakewalk, and if it's not, I'll retire from streaming and Let's Playing on the spot.
I sense turmoil within you.
Give me my points back. All of my points.
Safe journey.
Okay. Force Wave, Rending Force. What I really want is Internal Trauma, which is a lot of points away. Do that. We're eventually going to be going hard into Soldier anyways. I think I would rather immediate killing potential. Okay, Blitz and Force Wave. And our DPS looks mostly the same. But our shield charge should be doing just an asinine amount of damage. A couple thousand. Yeah. Our previous attacks were doing 900. And these are doing 2,000. So to half of... Well, that's not bad. I mean, you're making good progress then. Because, I mean, you've only been playing that for, like, what, 2 weeks now, give or take? It's not bad. I'm pretty sure that they have a bunch of post-game content, too. Oh, yeah. That's the ticket. I missed you, blessed Blitz. Just charging into groups of enemies and watching them all go flying. And we'll respec into shield throw and stuff, like, once we have access to, like, gear that actually gives us proper damage. We need to get to, like, Act 2 in the base game, because that's where we can get, like, a bunch of plus fire damage stuff, and that'll help us a lot. I do need to remind myself that we do not have Force Wave yet to a point where it does a bunch of damage over time. Because the third upgrade for Force Wave causes it to do just a shitload of internal trauma damage, which is physical damage over time. ? 68 hours? No, that's probably about appropriate. To my understanding, Persona 5's typically, like, if you're being fairly thorough, like, 100 hours, 120 hours. I'm glad you're enjoying it, though. That makes me happy to hear. The older games, like, if you're looking for more, Persona 4, to my understanding, based on what I've seen of 5, Persona 4 is very, very similar. If you go back to the earlier ones, though, they're much different. Like, in the first 3, you actually don't control your party members. And it can be incredibly frustrating. Because you'll have, like, one character that you're like, I just need to hit this thing one more time, and your character's like, nah, I'm gonna just heal the party instead. You only ever control your main character. I think, now that I think about it, I think Persona 4 was actually like that too, but they changed it in one of the re-releases. They made it so you could control everybody. Take it easy, Philosophizer. Get some sleep, man. Good luck with the inevitable hangover. Stand in it. We don't care. We've got Blitz and Force Wave. The DPS is our oyster. And we don't even have the thing for Blitz that makes it, like, a proper AoE yet either. One of the upgrades for it basically gives it, like, a 300 degree arc, I think. Like, things are only safe if they're, like, directly behind you, basically. Nuts. Yeah, definitely doing better damage now. That pleases me. Oh, knocked him into the lava. Bad day. I do not need the vital essence. God, this pack size on these enemies. This would have been a nightmare if I hadn't swapped my skills over to stuff that actually kills enemies. We'd be fighting these things for just years. This Let's Play would go longer than Kingmaker. Oh god, the SMT games are very different from Persona. The Shin Megami Tensei games, in a lot of ways, to me, kind of, like, they always reminded me more of, like, the old Wizardry games, where they were very, very much just about, like, the dungeon diving, as opposed to necessarily the story stuff. There was story stuff, obviously, but... And they were, like, fucking hard, too. Although, I think they released a new Shin Megami Tensei game recently, didn't they, I think? But I haven't played any of those since I don't even know what. Soul Hackers 2, I am not familiar with that. That's a name that I have not heard before. Is that the new Shin Megami Tensei? Or is that just its own game?
Thank you.
I'm not even gonna bother fighting those things. They are just buckets of obnoxious hit points that I don't wanna deal with. Y'all can just stay back there. And you guys just do what you want.
Do that yet.
Fucking love Blitz so much. Oh my god. Another spin-off of Shin Megami Tensei. Alright. I hope it's good. Like, I was gonna say, like, as far as I know, like, there hasn't been a Shin Megami Tensei game since, like, PS2 era? Or no, I take that back. If I had to guess, there were probably releases on, like, the Vita or something. Because, like, Persona, they kind of went hard into, like, the handheld stuff. Because that's where you could get, like, for the longest time, that was the only place you could get, Oh, I think it's the Persona 3 remake that's really good. You can only get it on, like, the Vita. Oh, hey. That's not nice. That's not nice. What's dropping the deathmatch? Is that you? No, you're just vampiric. There's a mage. Oh, there's the mage. He's the other unique in the pack. Whoa, hey. Hit points. Shin Megami Tensei 5. Ah, okay. Gotcha. I should see how those compare to, like, the old ones. Because, like, I think there were Shin Megami Tensei games on, like, the Game Boy or something, like... I think it was actually, like, the legit Game Boy. Come on. Kill the things. Mage is nasty. We're slowly whittling things down. Dang. Oh, I forgot to turn on my aura. Ah, video games. No, oh, and that's a statue. Wonderful. Just fucking wonderful. Upside, the human enemies are pretty squishy. Okay, let's work through this dude's hit point pool.
Skills not ready.
I mean, I'm glad to see them branching out a little bit. Like, Atlas is... They're a company that I've always kind of, like, underdog. Like, they've always struck me as kind of like an underdog company. Like, they should be a bigger name than they are, given some of their properties.
Can't do that yet.
Okay, what kind of goodies do we have here? I assume most likely a bunch of garbage that I can't actually do anything with. But, oh look. Yeah, it's a bunch of crap I can't do anything with. Wonderful. Hey, Arcurus, welcome. Hope you're doing well. Glad to see ya. That is not an upgrade. Oh, hey, a travel log. Stop writing books, game devs. Holy shit. Last night we reached the Badlands around the Valley of the Chosen, where we made camp along a jagged ridgeline just over the crest. As far as the eye could see, the harsh volcanic landscape was dotted with tomb entrances and monuments whose golden inlays sparkled in the bright moonlight, all of which were centered along a main corridor of grand burial crypts. It was an equally exhilarating and daunting sight, as I was not looking forward to traversing volcanic rock and leaping over molten rivers, and I have to say there's been some strange goings-on as we draw nearer to our goal. This morning I could swear... The earth itself shook me awake, and in the last fitful moments of sleep I dreamt of being consumed by fire, sinking deeper and deeper into an endless ocean of flame. As I jerked back to the realm of waking, I saw Amel sleeping like a freshly suckled pig, clutching his empty rum cask like the teat of a generous mother. It must have been in my head, perhaps an anxious dream brought on by the anticipation of the final leg of our journey, that the riches might be buried in the valley ahead. But later, as we broke camp, I noticed something very peculiar. We arrived last night well after sunset, and I would have bet my life we made our camp at the foot of a massive statue. This morning it was missing. I was dumbstruck. Not only was it gone, but there were gargantuan footprints leading away from it, like those of a man wearing heavy boots, only many times larger. They were deep, and the stride was long, as if some statue had walked off in the night, or some massive man had slung it over his shoulder and made off with it. When I told Amel, he seemed surprised at first, but then brushed it off. He insisted there was no statue, and that the full moon played a cruel trick on me. I think he saw it too. I'm certain of it, but he's so focused on finding treasures that he won't admit to any distractions. If that weren't enough, as we made our way down to the valley, I could swear I saw an entire caravan of men and women dressed in long gray robes with heavy armor off in the distance. They were traveling northward along the ridgeline next to the tombs, chanting as they went. By the time I got Amel to stop gaping at the gold inlay in the temple door we were going to pry open, he missed seeing them entirely. I feel as though I'm losing my mind, but I'm quite positive we are not alone here. I don't suppose it matters much at this point. We've reached our goal. The tomb marked on Amel's map is right beneath our feet. This one, among so many, supposedly holds grand riches. Perhaps once we're inside, I can breathe easy, away from all the weirdness happening out here, if we can figure out how to get the damn thing open.
Okay.
Got some good news. Lay it on me, Phoenix. What's going down, man?
That skill's not ready.
Oh, that's a lot of uniques. And by a lot, I mean two. But I'm terrible, and so I'm afraid of everything at this point. We have yet to hit peak god mode on this character. It's about 30 levels away, and probably not within the scope of this playthrough. There are enemies everywhere! Fucking things dropping fire all over the place. Mother of God. Shit! That was close. No! Quit it! Man, it's a shame that like Twitch is so bitchy about watching movies on here. I would totally stream like a watching of the Dungeons and Dragons movie. I hate that movie so much, but Jeremy Irons makes it watchable. That man chews the set like no other. Right. Violence done. We got a shield out of it. That gives fire damage, which as of right now doesn't really do much for me. Ooh, retaliation damage though. We're not there yet. We're not there yet. The retaliation build comes later. Once we have, you know, actual equipment. Oh, hey. Oh, man, I don't want to fight you guys. You got like a jillion hit points and I hate you. Yeah, the hit points don't matter as much now that we have Blitz. I take that back. I'll fight all of you. Easy. GG. It's ridiculous just how much better the soldier skills are. Like, compared to the Oathkeeper skills. Like, why? I mean, I'm sure it's in part because, like, our Oathkeeper skills deal fire damage, and I basically completely ignored it. But I'm instead going to just blame it on Soldier being that damn good. Escape the Manticore random encounter death trap. Nice. But you're on a different one with some trolls. There are some really nasty troll fights in Kingmaker. Like, that is, I think one of that game's failings is that they way overtuned some monsters. Like owl bears are nuts in that game. Some of the trolls that you fight are just absolutely absurd. And, like, I get why they did it, because it's a six-man party instead of a four-man first off, but, like, holy shit. Some of those fights are just harrowing. Somebody's going on about their pain. The full-plate owlbear, oh my god. You mean as a DM, you don't, like, put barding on all of your random monster encounters, Arcturus? Come on now. And then they just start stacking on all, like, the random templates. Hey, Elo, welcome. Hope you're doing well today. Glad to have you along. Grim Harvest boots, you say? We'll look at those in a moment. What are these? Fucking no! Quit giving me necromancer shit! Give me things I can use! Petulant Let's Player. Ooh. Ow, it's caster armor. Dang it. And the resistance is under pretty bad. It's got 6% physical resist. That's pretty good. Physical resistance can be pretty tough to raise. Nothing too crazy. Well, you've just gotta offset it, though. And I mean, like, really, well, I don't know, I'm not familiar enough with the barding rules to be like, just give them, like, enough to give them enough AC that it's just really obnoxious. Give them, like, the equivalent of, like, chain shirt barding. Min-max that shit, yo. Barding defeats the purpose of it. Eh, I suppose so. Like, I agree with you with regards to random encounters. I could totally see, like, some group of, like, monster hunters or something having, like, a pack of dogs that they hunt with that they've got, like, armor on. But yeah, I agree. Like, you're not going to be, like, wandering around in nature and, like, here is a dire bear that just inexplicably has plate mail on. That's a funny image, though. Stack the advanced template. True. True. The advanced template is so great. That is like one of the greatest things to come out of Pathfinder. Monster not tough enough, just add two to everything and it works. I hear the sounds of violence. We're here to help. Okay. More garbage. In the troll trouble, you're stopped in the area. Find the mage. Okay, well, if you're in the area where you have to find the mage, you're almost done with it then, at least. Those aren't bad shoulders. I wish it was like elemental damage converted to physical damage instead of piercing, though. It's like the ideal for us with how we are currently would be to get 100% conversion of non-physical damage to physical damage. Writings of Rion the Scholar. Alright. Well, that way lies progress, I assume, so we're gonna backtrack. We have side areas to explore. We desperately need the experience. Sounds like the Phoenix Party needs more fireball. Exactly! Never enough fireball. There are very few problems fireball can't solve. And, Wrath of the Righteous actually made Evoker Wizards, like, super, super good. Because they gave you the, I think it's called the Elementalist archetype, and it basically lets you, your elemental spells, like, ignore spell resistance, or not spell resistance, energy resistance of, like, a given type. And also any elemental spell that deals, like, electric damage or cold damage, it deals your chosen elemental type. So you can have, like, chain lightning spells dealing, like, fire damage and shit. It's crazy. That's probably the route that Rove will be taking when I inevitably get to Wrath of the Righteous. It's gonna be a good time. Okay, and we have a monster shrine up here. Yeah, I remember that, where you had, like, all your fire domain clerics and stuff. I like that as an idea. I'd be curious to see how it would actually, like, carry through the entire game. Because, I mean, Fireball only does 10d6, but with, like, meta magic rods and stuff, you could make that do some work. I love Blitz so much. It is so friggin' good. Maybe I'll just go Blitz and keep Shield Throw instead of Force Wave. But Blitz is just too good to give up. Holy shit, that's 4 uniques? That is not numbers I'm prepared to stand and fight. You want to see my Rod of Enlarge?
That skill's not ready.
or perhaps you would prefer to see my Extend Metamagic Rod. Yeah, that's true. Then basically the only thing you'd need to really worry about is like getting your save DCs to the point where they're high enough. Which, given how fucking cheesy some of the later fights in that game are, would probably be pretty tough. Because, like, when I played through it, like, there's an elemental robe specifically for fire elemental damage in that. Like, I had Rove using that, and, like, on his higher level stuff, things were still occasionally failing saves. And you just can't have that when it's the Wild Hunt. Only have damage, just keep casting. You're not wrong. And then the other trick is to take heightened spell so that you can spend all of your higher level spell slots on just more fireballs. So what can you cast, Kyra? Fireball. What else? Fireball. Yeah, but like, what about healing or raise dead? Fireball. Don't need to heal anything when everybody's on fire. We gotta go sell shit. Vanguard of 3. Just dump all this crap that we've got. I don't know why fucking Discord isn't saying I'm streaming.
We'll give you a good
it's like you're playing Grim Dawn. It's got streamer mode enabled. Won't say I'm streaming. I might have to update my Twitch API key or something.
See you around.
36 fireballs per rest, Jesus Christ. Ah, that's pretty glorious. Keep casting, man. I mean, if it works. So let me know, answer. Yeah, like, I don't know. Twitch is being fucky, and I don't know why. And it's to the point now where I've just kind of given up trying. Oh, no, 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 no. All right, good talk. Hey, Questy, welcome. Hope you're doing well. Glad to have you on board. Exactly, it's not stupid if it works. You do you. Path is sealed by a powerful ruin without... Ruin. Rune. Without knowledge of its creation, it's impossible to remove it. Alright, bye. Wait a minute. Do I need the fucking... You gotta get warnings. Don't spoil. Don't be a dipshit. Don't talk politics. I don't even remember what other rules I have. How did the quest for damage end up? I respec'd from Oathkeeper for damage into Soldier, and now we're kicking everything's asses. Soldier is just the superior tree at this point in the game until we can get some fire damage.
Need stashed.
Okay, no, we gotta go to the path of the damned for the last seal, that's right. Pop-Tart is baked ravioli. I gotta get my bot to ban you, Jim. Holy shit. Yeah, don't backseat. Thank you, Arcurus. No backseating. Allow me to fail on my own merits. Horribly. Say there's a mage back there lobbing some fire spells at us. Quit it. I don't even know what's going on. I'm just surrounded by particle effects.
That skill's not ready.
Why don't I go? Oh my god. Ugh. Eela, no.
Can't do that yet.
don't do... Man, no, the one that got me... I was programming in C-sharp, and I mentioned that I was programming in C-sharp, and somebody's like, why don't you program it in F-sharp? I'm like, Unity doesn't even support that. No one supports that. Take your fucking Spanglish programming language and get the fuck out. It's just like, oh my god. Freaking people. I don't give a shit about your pet programming language. I'm just here to make shitty games. Ugh.
I can't do that yet.
I always liked watching Cinnatar when people would backseat him, because he was totally okay with it until the moment that he realized that they were talking out of their asses. And then he would just shit all over them, and it was so good. So good. Bunch of crap. Fuck off, statue. That's right. Everybody get all clumped up here. Clump up. Ah, oh, feels good, man. I love Blitz so much. Well, yeah. Like, I don't mind advice. Advice doesn't bother me at all. It's as soon as you're like, Gene, do this, then we have a problem. You can point me in the right direction, and I'll happily take that, sure. Q basic, oh my god.
That skill's not ready.
I'm gonna program this in like Visual C6. Let me just boot up my 486 over here. 2 megabytes of RAM.
I can't do that yet.
It's gonna be a WoW killer. People have no idea what they're talking. Exactly. Exactly it. And that's the kind of folks that, like, Sin would just, like, he would flat out tell them, like, you know, just don't even bother commenting if you have no idea what you're talking about. That man was delightfully blunt sometimes. Aurora in the back of the room, basically built in Excel. Oh no! Questy, you've done it. We'll make our game in Microsoft Excel. There you go. Because you can do calculated sheets. I think you can program... What is it? You can program in some programming language in Excel. Is it like ASP or something? Or is it like Visual or Basic? I don't remember. But I know you can actually have like programming in Excel sheets. Make Doom run in there, except it's Visual Basic. Alright. So yeah, like, there you go. That's enough. It begins. First time I noticed you actually listened to something I said was Vaporum. Aww. I listen to you occasionally, Jem. I listen to most people until they prove themselves unworthy. I arrived today at the heart of the Corvin City after a grueling 3 days' travel, a journey which began on a high note as we traversed the lush oasis just beyond the walls of the Cairn docks. The Corvin capital is something else entirely. Lush stands of palms grace the shores of flowing streams fed by subterranean springs which bubble up from the depths with an irrepressible ferocity. In the midst of a stark desert, it is truly a sight to behold. I've been told that one source provides the cleanest waters in this region. Apparently, an entire class of water merchants exist with the sole duty of collecting the life-giving nectar from there and distributing it throughout the land. This is also where I had my first exposure to the curious and deep-rooted faith of the region. My traveling companions, the daily caravan from the Cairn docks to Corvin City, insisted that we stop at a temple known as the Sanctuary of Haran, positioned in the heart of the oasis. It was apparently crucial that they stop while the burning sun was at its highest point, the prescribed hour to observe a daily ritual in which they give thanks to their god for his mercy and pittance. I can understand why a culture surrounded by such harsh and unforgiving lands would be grateful to whatever it has that has graced them to create such a stunning civilization. However, I quickly learned to be wary of these rituals, as the prescribed hour for worship is not one, but several a day. I now know why the journey to Corvin City takes 3 days. On the second day of our journey, we passed through a smaller city on the outskirts of Corvin. This was truly an unusual locale. It appeared to be more temple than practical residence. I surmised it is a center for religious practice, perhaps where the local faith's most devout followers can go about their various rituals unhindered by the bustle of Corvin proper. Just beyond the city temple, or the temple city, lies a vast network of tombs. I was told by one of the caravan's drivers that previous Corvin leaders and powerful devotees of the Corvin faith are buried there along with countless precious relics. Apparently the valley was chosen as a burial site because the roiling hot blood of their god flows close to the surface there. I suspect there's an ancient magma flow passing beneath the valley, perhaps the remnants of a long dormant volcano. These revelations are quite curious and worthy of further investigation. I shall hope to learn a great deal more about this faith, its practices, and practitioners during my time in Corvin City. What are you guys going on about in chat? Holy shit. Dungeon Master is the most superior dungeon crawler. Have I ever said that? Really? Anvil of Dawn? No, it's Lands of Lore, you silly, silly European man. But no, Dungeon Master is really fucking good.
Please, set
oh, God damn
relax
it.
And free yourself from the bonds of our planet as we take off for the stars. Stars. Planet as we stars. Stars.
Hello, Darius. I hope you're well. But nah, Destructo, you didn't really miss anything. We've just been, like, basically catching up to where we were last time. Did not, however, come in here. Nah, Dungeon Master is great. I've actually been... I was contemplating, like, replaying Dungeon Master and Dungeon Master 2 on stream. Like, before we get into... Before we get into, Baldur's Gate 2 again. Several hour binge of Elden Ring. Oh god. Elden Ring is so good. So good! Oh my god! Tiggy only run? Oh god. See, like, that's the thing, is I was contemplating that, like, if I played Dungeon Master, oh, I'd let you guys pick characters, but then I knew exactly what would happen. I'd have, like, the stunty squad. It'd be Tiggy, that fucking dwarf,
that skill's
and
not
Lord
written.
Knows who else. That's basically where I am too, Questy. Like, it follows, like, the Diablo 3 and Bloodborne, like, hyper-aggressive style of, like, boss fights, and I'm just, like, really bad at that. But the open world is just so good. So good. And the game is friggin' beautiful. Oh my god. No. Scorched note. There's nowhere left to go. Nowhere to run. I got separated from Amal when a cave-in blocked the passage into the depths of the tomb. In his typical and natural calm, he said to go on, that we'd meet up further down. But as I walked, the earth began to shake. Groaning and rumbling, the bedrock beneath the temple cried out like a waking beast. Why is this scrolling both windows? Weird. I panicked and began to run, but every step... Where was I? I lost myself. Every step seemed to aggravate the beast further. I made it less than 20 feet before the shaking brought me to my knees. I continued to crawl, scraping my arms against the jagged stone floor with no concept of where I was going, no plan to escape. With a bone-shattering crack, the floor of the temple opened like a gaping maw, revealing the right white-hot river of flame below. I could not have imagined the depth of terror that consumed me in that moment as Amal's desperate screams echoed through the passage behind me. I somehow summoned the courage to move and dragged myself away from the searing heat. For a time, I cowered there as the tomb shook around me, its groans and cracks resembling an oppressive voice that called out to me. They called out to all living things from the depths of the fiery river that flowed around me. Then, as the shaking subsided, there was a calm. I could hear the other cracks and booms in far-off places, but the temple I lay in was still. Now there is nothing but the sizzle and drone of the molten earth that now defines the island of solid rock that will be my final resting place. There are no riches, no treasure, only burning death and the voice that beckons me into the flames. Yeah, I'm at like almost 20 hours over the last 2 days. I put like 12 hours into it today. I basically woke up and played it until it was time to stream. I'm behind on my day job. Oh well, but yes, Elden Ring is really, really, really good. So good. sick all day with a stomach bug. Oh, I am so sorry. So sorry to hear that, Destructo. Stomach bugs are fucking terrible. But at least you have crackers and Sprite. Renette the Rat God. Oh, hey, level up. Oh my god! Look at this! Look at this! Paragraphs! Why? I just want to kill stuff. I came here to do violence, not to read. Renette was not always a rat and did not always preside over the vermin and lowly creatures of the Corvin Basin. He was once a powerful and proud man, a merchant whose wealth rivaled any who bask in the light of Ron. But he was not born into the life of wealth and power. No, he was born a diseased and lowly vagrant to a widowed mother, with nothing more to give him than her faith in the Eldritch Sun. And so, unable to care for her sickly child, she prayed to her god and pledged her own life so that Renette could be spared the plight that was his birthright. The desperate mother's prayers were answered, and miraculously, the infant grew to become a healthy child. A young man, Renette, was conscripted to the service of the trade ship, where it is said that even the cruel sea showed him favor. He grew strong and clever in his service, and his skill as a sailor brought him much renown. He worked furiously to honor the life he was given, and through his drive and dedication, became the captain of a ship on which he served. His success at sea was so great that he would one day return to the Cairn docks from their command an armada of ships that sailed in his name. It was from this position of power that he built his grand wealth, and from which he began to forget his humble origins. The success of his life so tainted his ego that Renette began to believe he was destined for greatness, that a life such as his could not be a coincidence. He sought greater power and forgot the gift that was given. Those who served or were loyal to Renette showered him with adoration, and his pride grew with his wealth. The shade of his origins was all but forgotten as Renette proclaimed himself the master of the seas and commissioned the first of many temples to be constructed in his honor. Quickly, sailors and seafarers began paying tribute, leaving riches and treasures at these sites of worship. It was said that the favor of Renette bestowed good fortune upon those who took to the sea. Some even perceived him as a god of the waters, an ascendant whose legends spread beyond even the Corvin waters. But the grand hubris of Renette drew the ire of his benefactor, and so the Eldritch Sun left his throne, disguised himself as an elderly vagrant so he could walk amongst the people of Corvin Basin. There he heard the adulation for Renette, listened as the people spoke of the man as if he stood among Korvac's chosen. Those few mortals who served and dedicated to the Eldritch Sun had earned them a place aside his throne. This rightly enraged the divine, and in his disguised form he sought court with the self-appointed god of the seas. In a grand temple built in his name, Renette met with the old man. He laughed at the sight of that sickly and broken creature before him. "What have you to give the master of the seas, you poor old fool?" asked Renette. "I have come to remind you of the life you should have lived," the man said meekly. "I am you as you should have been, were it not for the kindness of the Eldritch Sun." Renette laughed once again. "You have come here to threaten me. Who are you to speak to the gods? Speak for the gods. How dare you?" And with that, the old man's voice boomed, shaking the earth beneath their feet. His form twisted and grew as he spoke, and a blistering heat washed over Renette, burning away his clothes, peeling and bubbling his flesh. "I do not come to threaten, I have come to collect upon the gift which was given." The searing heat cleansed Renette of his pride, and he cowered before the towering figure. "Forgive me," begged Renette, "I did not know." "What have you to give me, you poor little creature?" the figure boomed. "I give my life," cried Renette. "Indeed, but death is too small a price. No, you shall serve me as the lowliest of creatures you have always been. You will hold court over those who saw you as a god." With those final words, Renette's body collapsed upon itself, twisting, tearing, and grinding, until finally he appeared as a massive, diseased rat. His temples were brought to ruin. His temples were brought to ruin in an instant, and from the rubble emerged a swarm of rats. All of those who had followed the master of the sea, all who had pledged their loyalty to him or begged for his favor, were cursed to live out their days as vile vermin in the service of the rat god. Take heed of the story of Renette, for all things that we cherish in life are gifts of the Eldritch Sun. Damn. Okay, level physique. I'm gonna just dump points into soldier. The sooner we get to blindside, the better. And I missed like all of chat. Oh, let's see. Oh man, Kingdoms of Amalur. I have tried to play that game so many times, and I always just bounce off of it so hard. You're a wise man, Ela. It wasn't anything particularly great. Just the typical, like, a dude was blessed by a god, hubris happened, god got pissed and turned him into a rat. I just summarized all of those paragraphs in like two sentences.
Notion that we quite like to sail the ocean, so we're building a big boat to leave here for good. We're not keen on sinking, so we're all sitting here and thinking, cause we built it too big and we've run out of wood. Idle, idly, idle, idly, we simply can't leave till we get some more wood.
Good stuff. God was a cat, basically. I tried to play Lost Ark, and then I realized it was basically like every other Korean MMO, got bored and stopped. I gave it a couple hours, but I just can't. Sadly. Game's pretty though, I'll give it that.
I can't do that.
These things are chonky, boys.
Skills not ready.
28 hours in since Sunday. Damn. I'm glad you're having a good time of it, I suppose. Yeah, that's a thing, Kibitz. It's like,
I can't do that.
I don't know. It's one of those things where, like, I started playing it. And I'm like, yeah, this is okay. And then the more I played it, like, I don't want to say it wasn't deep. But like, I don't know, it didn't really scratch like the action RPG itch, and that's what I wanted. So I was just like, pass. Okay, anything good? A shield for elementalists, which I am not. And some pikes, which are two-handed, which I do not. That everybody, or are there more? I think there are probably more. Yes.
I can't do that yet.
Can't do the Diablo style loot fest? I mean, in that case, you might actually dig on it, Dar, because it isn't quite like Diablo. It's more. Like, with regards to loot, it's kind of more like a traditional MMO, where, like, you just get, like, a new set of gear every handful of levels.
See anything you like.
Which is one of the reasons I fell off of it, because, like, I want, like, this kind of loot. Take it easy, Kibitz. Have a good one. Ooh.
Iron well spent.
This chest armor. That is some chunky armor right there. I might actually swap over that. That's a lot of health and health regen and speed. This fanaticism on hit, attack speed, cast speed. Nice. Thank you much, Lee Kibitz. Oh my god, fucking Tangled Deep, that game. I wanted to like Tangled Deep so good, so much, but that game, I have tried to play through it multiple times, and like, it's good, it's good, it's good, and then it just hits a wall where the difficulty just goes just completely to shit, and it goes from feeling really good to play to just incredibly frustrating. Now, if you want a roguelike that you can just really chew on and like punch through without like a crazy asinine amount of effort, like Dungeon Man's is pretty solid for that. Like, it's got numbers to it, but it's not insane like Tangled Deep is. Oh man, Valheim is really good. Admittedly, I've only played it through the second boss, but I really enjoyed the time that I put into Valheim. Tangled Deep, well, I mean, yeah, Jim helped develop Tangled Deep, but he wasn't the primary developer behind it. Zircon was. The dude that actually did the music for Dungeon Mans is the lead developer behind Tangledeep. But yeah, Dungeon Mans is probably, if I had to like pick an action RPG to just like play forever, it would probably be Dungeon Mans. Because it like scratches the itch between like, it's got some mechanical depth to it, but it's not asinine. And for the most part, there's not too much bullshit in it. And like, you always feel like you're progressing. It's just a satisfying game.
The skill's not ready.
Difficult to heat up a pizza slice and toppings won't fall off. The trick to heating up a pizza slice, it's a pain in the ass, but it's the best way to reheat pizza. You put it in a frying pan on your stove and you throw the heat on high and give it like 2 minutes. Once it starts sizzling on the bottom a little bit, you sprinkle like literally a couple drops of water in there and then you put a lid on it. And that will give you a crispy crust on the bottom and melty cheese and toppings on top, and it's fucking great. That having been said, I never do it, and I just eat, like, reheated pizza cold because I'm a lazy heathen, but it is what it is. Yeah, that's basically how I felt Tangledeep was as well, Dar. Is that, like, the game feels really good, and then it doesn't. And it just comes out of nowhere. Bring cold pizza slices in the microwave. I mean,
not ready yet.
Yeah, I'd be lying if I said I don't do the same.
I can't do that yet.
Go down, old man. Come on. There we go. Yeah, like, that's the other thing is, like, Tangledeep's combat, like, in the early game, you can kind of just, like, you know, putz your way through it. You know, do violence upon things and get by, and then it very much becomes a game where, like, every turn you have to put some serious thought into, like, what you're going to do. And that's when the fun kind of ceases. It's like, no, I don't want this at all. Oh, slow cooked pot roast. Nice! Dang fucking Germans and your delicious foodstuffs. Always making tasty things. So jealous. Well, this is obviously something, but we can't get past it. Let me steal goldfish crackers. I don't even have snack foods. I got coffee and water. They fortify me. I'm trying to cut down on the snack foods. It's hard and I hate it, but it needs to happen. I haven't had goldfish in so long. Holy shit. I could really go for some goldfish. Yeah, that's rough. Like, that's my problem too, is that, like, I'll typically have, like, a smaller meal during the day, and then I go to work at night, and I get home, and I'm, like, super, super hungry. And I need to not just stuff my face with everything, and then immediately go to bed. But that's what I do. And it's like, oh, this is why I'm gaining weight. Complete and utter lack of self-control. Oh, hey. Spawn of a Teth. Alright, so we got, like, demons now. Look like something out of Diablo. You did, in fact, just hear goldfish. Oh, the spawn of a Teth is actually on our side. Okay, sure, I'll take it. I think I just hit that thing for like 8,000 damage. I've never actually had any type of goldfish except the regular ones. I didn't even know they made different types of goldfish. I've actually been wanting, like, I've been craving Cheez-Its of all things, which, like, I haven't had a Cheez-It in probably a decade. But, for whatever reason, there it is. Are still good. Glad to hear it. I want to try. They've got like the puffed ones. Those look pretty good. I think I would probably like those. And I'm just generally one that, like, I'm not big on. I shouldn't say I'm not big. I just don't generally crave like salty snack foods. What are you doing out here? We've shared goals. We're here to search for Father Kaiman, to put a stop to his madness. I'm also looking for him. And we are allies. Who are you? Brothers and sisters of the Order of Death's Vigil. So these are the dudes you can ally with these guys in the main campaign. Alright, what do you know about Father Kaiman? I know very little, but his story is a tragic one. Despite the effort his and his army of zealots put into hunting down our order, I still have empathy for him. I truly believe he thought he could save us all, though he was doing what needed to be done to save Cairn. But I fear he was misled from the very beginning, used as a tool of revenge. Kaiman, one of the guys of Empyrean, Lesved, you mean Korvac? Yes. We now know the truth behind Kaiman's lunacy, a forgotten god that forged a new faith under the guise of Empyrean. Yeah, we'll stop him. Alright, thanks for random lore dump, dude bro. I appreciate you. Okay. Oh my god, no, not another one. Is it a book? Not really. Today was my first full day in Corvin City, and I must say that I am as awestruck by its majesty as I was when I first landed at the Cairn Docks. The focal point of the city is a grand temple dedicated to the Eldritch Sun, Korvac, a deity I am unfamiliar with, but one that dominates local theology. The temple's majesty is indescribable. It seems to dwarf everything in sight, even nearby mountains, and it radiates with such an energy that its heat can be felt even in the midday sun. Even I, a skeptic, find myself in sheer admiration. I've been told the heat of the temple had dwindled for some years, but has recently rekindled, a cause for celebration and ritual. I suspect it is built on a geological feature, perhaps a volcano or hot spring of some sort. I should very much wish to gain access to the inside, though as I discovered by visiting several smaller temples around the city, this is unlikely to happen. The main temple holds particular importance, and entry is strictly prohibited to outsiders. Though it appears to be the focal point of the local faith, Korvac is by no means the only entity worshipped by the Corvin people. There also appear to be lesser gods, whom the people call Ascendants. What that means exactly I am not clear on, and nobody has a straight answer for me either. The stories regarding these individuals vary, and not all of them seem to be holy men or even devout practitioners. By my observations, they may well be wealthy individuals that have bought their way to deification, and the social reverence that comes with. Nonetheless, minor temples were constructed in their honor, and they are all worshipped in their own right and for various means, sometimes even before death. I should very much like to know what qualifies a person for a place of such honor, and so tomorrow I will visit several temples positioned around the main temple of the Eldritch Sun. If birthright will not grant me access, then perhaps the grease of a few coins will. Take it easy, Arcurus. Good luck. Almain Cheetos. Another one! Fucking lore notes. I remember this happened in my last playthrough and I ended up just stopping reading them. Yeah, Cheetos are another thing that I haven't had for ages. Man. When I was a kid, like, you can get, like, the Cheeto Puffs and stuff. There were Cheeto Paws. They were shaped like the Cheetah's paws. I think they brought them back a handful of years ago. I don't know if they're still around. But I remember those being a particularly choice snack in my household.
That skill's not ready.